Excuse me, please.
Thank you.
Stanmore in her role as patron of healthy aged. As Mark Wadsworth reports, she took pains to observe the traditional Islamic customs of her home.
Princess Diana arrived wearing a designer hat. She was presented with flowers by 2 5-year-old girls before going past the men's section of the Islamic Centre. She emerged in stocking feet from the strictly separate women's section, wearing a traditional hijab headscarf given to her by one of the women. The royal patron of Help the Aged had no problem observing the Islamic custom. This was in stark contrast to the obstacles faced by two Muslim girls who today spoke about winning their battle to wear headscarves at school in Greater Manchester. Princess Di impressed her hosts.
Both sides, we tried and kept the royal protocol, and she was quite happy to go along with the traditions that we have. And I think it was a very, very nice thing. On my side, I'm very pleased for the community, in the sense that we have been able to show a good image of the community, where we're trying to see that we can build up good relationships with the outside world. And also, we are happy to show to the people what we're doing here.
The Mercedes-Shia Islamic Centre at Stanmore, which cost £4.2 million raised from donations, caters for a London-based community of Indian Muslims. There are religious and social activities for young and old alike. Here, the princess was shown bookbinding. Later, she was presented with a special copy of the Holy Quran. Elders at the centre said they'd like a visit from the Queen and Prince Charles next. Mark Wordsworth, Thames News.
The Prime Minister has been touring at Stanmore in Middlesex. The Husseini Shia Centre is the first in the world to offer facilities for young children and the elderly in the Islamic community. The Princess, who is patron of Help the Aged, was given a tour of the facilities.
A man?
The Worshipful, the Mayor of Harrow, Councillor Mrs. Phyllis Harkett, the Member of Parliament for Harrow East, Mr. Hugh Dykes, the Chairman of Help the Aged, Mr. William Menzies Wilson, the President of the London Community, and distinguished guests. It gives us great pleasure to welcome you all on behalf of the community and the Senior Citizens Association. Your Royal Highness, my community feels very much honoured by your presence here, and thanks you most earnestly for having sacrificed your precious time to visit us. We will always cherish the memory of your visit with happiness, pleasure, and pride. My community, known as the Khoja Shia Isnashris, comprises of 100,000 members worldwide, of whom about 5,000 are settled in England. Almost all of us come from Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania. My community will remain eternally indebted to Her Majesty's government for the magnanimous gesture to those from Uganda who arrived here in 1972 during the Exodus. These members, most of whom are now very successful businessmen and professionals, recount with deep gratitude the extensive efforts made by the British government to settle them here. After the arrival and settlement of these members, we purchased a place for religious worship at Hammersmith in 1974, and then in 1984 bought this property, which was in a grossly dilapidated state. It has now been transformed into a magnificent centre with financial contributions from men and women, young and old, of the community. The history of this property dates back 200 years. It was built in the 19th century as a 90-room mansion and was once occupied by Sir Robert Smirk, an early 19th century architect of renown who designed the British Museum and the Royal Mint. From 1851 to 1890, it was owned by Charles Kayser, who received frequent visits from his great friend, King Edward VII. It then belonged to H.R. Bishop Shines, a city banker and hospital benefactor. Then it became an old people's home, then a Jewish educational center, and it was unoccupied for 12 years prior to it becoming an Islamic center. It is a center with multifarious activities like religious worship gatherings, a nursery school, indoor sports center, language classes, Quran classes, Islamic college, dressmaking classes, Senior Citizens Association, and many others. The Senior Citizens Association was started by myself in January 1988, when I perceived a great need for it for our respected elders, who, having got used to a small community environment in Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania found themselves very isolated here, particularly in the cold wintry days when they could not go out much. These are the same people who indoctrinated us in our childhood and taught us to be decent and loyal citizens of the country in which we reside. The Senior Citizens Association has progressed by leaps and bounds and is one of the most active arms of the center. The activities of the Senior Citizens Group include regular gatherings, English language classes, lectures on medical topics, religious lectures, knitting and sewing classes, discussion groups, and outings to places of interest like Windsor Safari Park, Milton Keynes, Ruislip Lido, and others. We are very grateful to Help the Aged for having donated half the cost towards the minibus and also to Age Concern for £1,000 to purchase a video camera and audio recorder for the use of our senior citizens. Your Royal Highness, during your visit today, you will be able to see some of the activities of the senior citizens and meet the members of the group. You will meet the children of the nursery school and be able to see some of their activities, and I'm told that they have a very pleasant surprise for you. Most of all, you will see some parts of this center, a center that my community has established with injection of substantial funds in order to restore it to its original splendor and architecture. May I take this opportunity to thank you all once again for your presence here. Your Royal Highness, we hope that this will be a memorable and an enjoyable visit for you. Thank you.